here. Hold on a second. We have a camera problem. Boy, there were technical issues tonight, my friends. I apologize. Bear with me. We're changing the camera. Bear with me. Boy, oh boy, I'll tell you what. There was an update literally as I click go live. Just give me a second. I'm here with you. Bob, the builder, is here to fix everything. I'm going to let him come in and do that. What a great way to start, right? With the paper, right? Happy Thanksgiving to you all. We are just days away from a big turkey holiday. I am a huge turkey lover. As soon as we get the cameras fixed up, I'll be right with you guys. So glad that you're here with me tonight. My name is Lisa Curcio, and I'd like to welcome you to Lisa's Stamp Studio. This is a YouTube live streaming event, if you haven't figured that out already. You never know what's going to happen with technology. Today is Monday, November 22nd. The year is 2021. Whether this is your very first time or you are returning to my channel, I'm thrilled that you are here with me. Thank you for joining me. Boy, do I have a card for you tonight. You are going to love it. It is a pop-up and pull-out funfold card. So basically, it's two cards in one. I know, it's kind of really interesting. I originally saw this idea from Sam Calcott from the UK. She has mixed up crafts. And of course, it was in centimeters, and I needed it in inches. Oh, I hope you guys are there. There we are. Hi. Okay. I apologize for that. Those of you that are here for the replay, hopefully it kind of skimmed just past that until we got right here. I'm going to wait till a comment pops up to make sure that you can actually see me now. My husband to the rescue. He's amazing. Thank you so much. Okay, the sound was cutting in and out. If you're having audio problems, please log out and then come back in. Welcome, welcome. I'm so glad that you guys are here. So I was telling you about tonight's fun fold, and I am excited about it because it's a pop-up card and a pull-out card all in one. And I was telling you how I got the idea from Mixed Up Crafts. Now, she's a UK paper crafter, and I love the idea, but of course, I had to reinvent all the dimensions. Now, I've seen this card fold before, but I had seen other pieces to make it. So I kind of tweaked everything to kind of make it my own, but I want to thank Sam for the inspiration. Now, before we get started, there's a couple really important things you need to know about tonight's live stream. First and foremost, there is going to be a free project sheet for you tonight. We're going to link it down in the video description below when tonight's live stream is over so that you can get the pictures, the cutting dimensions, and all the supplies, because I know you're going to want to make this funfold card. Next, I want to take a few minutes just to introduce you to Gina Curcio Holly. You'll see Gina's name here in blue with a little wrench next to her name. She is my YouTube moderator, but she is also my daughter. She's been stamping next to me for the entire 22 years I've been a demonstrator, and she is more than versed to be able to answer your questions and help you with links, because it is impossible to keep up with your comments while I'm trying to stamp. So she's here to help you. And we do love to hear from you. So whether you are here for the live stream or you are watching the replay, do me a favor, log in to your YouTube account, which is your Gmail address. That's a requirement of YouTube, not of me, in order to leave a comment or to chat. I come back and I read every single one. Now, the other thing I want you to know about is this. I'm going to switch screens really, really quick here. If you are like me and you love this time of year because of the sales, we've got a special for you here at Lisa's Stamp Studio. This is our second year in a row that we are doing this, and it's backed by popular demand. It's going to be on Cyber Monday only. So that's November 29th. You're going to see some details here on the screen. In exchange for a $75 product order before shipping and tax, you are going to receive a private invitation to Live with Lisa right here on YouTube. It is not public streamed. I would love to include you. You're going to get a bundle of 8 PDF tutorials. Now, these are tutorials with written step-by-step instructions, a picture, cutting dimensions, supplies, the whole 9 yards. One is a fun fold. It is a 17-page PDF tutorial. Lots of tips in there for you as well. And of course, because your order is going to be $50 or more, we're requiring $75 for the Cyber Monday special, you're going to be able to choose one of my product gifts from my gift list that goes out on the 25th of December. So we are really hopeful that you're going to be able to enjoy that. Here's a real quick cover photo here about how you can place your order and be involved. But you know what the easiest way is? To subscribe to my newsletter over on my website. Scroll down about halfway, it'll pop right up. All right, we'll talk a little bit more about that later. Let's get busy. All right, so this is just a regular piece of cardstock. This is 5.5 by 8.5, nothing fancy here. We're gonna do a couple score lines first. Now, my trimmer has both a scoring blade and a cutting blade. And I'm going to be using both tonight. And I love that I can keep them on the trimmer at the same time and they navigate up and down out of the way. So that's going to make life really, really easy. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to open this up and we're going to do two very simple score lines. The first one is at 2 1/8. And I love the straight ledge here at the top because I can't do anything straight. So I'm going to go ahead and close that and I am going to score. And then I'm going to slide over to 4 1/4, which is here. Now that same little margin there at the top to hold your paper straight is actually at the top and the bottom. I absolutely love that. All right, now I'm going to set this aside for just a minute. We are going to come back to this, and I'm kind of short on counter space today, so bear with me. And next thing we're going to do is we're going to crease up on these score lines. Now you might look at this and go, oh, I recognize that. That's a little breakaway Z fold. Yes, it is. Now, before we go to the next step, we're going to have to add our designer series papers. So I've got some cut here. I love this designer series paper. It's called Peaceful Place. Very simple color palette of grays, blacks, and whites, double-sided in case you love an alternative. And I just thought this was so wintry feeling. So we're going to go ahead and attach this first. This is going to be my wrong side tonight. I don't know if you can see it or not, but there are silver flecks of foil inside this pretty side I'm covering. I know one of you is thinking, why are you covering that? Well, it's going to go better tonight. Now, since I don't do too many things straight, I'm going to open that up. I'm going to make it nice and flat and easy for my hand, and I'm looking to navigate that so that it's centered as good as possible. Now, here in the center, I'm going to do another piece of designer series paper. This is all from the same packet. Now, this one's got silver foils on it, too. Isn't that beautiful? And again, double-sided, so you have more choices. I'm going to use that pretty shiny side. Now, I did opt to teach you this on a Christmas card, although the thumbnail for tonight's video, when we're done with the stream, is going to show you a birthday card. So I've got not only this one, but a birthday card. But guess what? I have several others to share with you as well. But the birthday card and this one are both going to be included in your project sheet. I just want to get that adhesive back there. And the others are just going to be bonuses for tonight's live stream. All right, so pretty simple, right? Now here is where we're going to put another piece of designer series paper. So this is going to kind of tell a whole story as we're done. Again, same papers, I just chopped it up. And again, keep in mind that all those cutting dimensions are going to be inside your project sheet. Now I want to tell you here, I probably should have told you too on this first one, you're going to be generous with your adhesive all the way around because we are going to do a little bit of cutting here to create that pop out. So let's go ahead and center this here as well. And then when it looks good, I'm looking at the top there to try to make them even, and then we'll tack that in place. All right, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to bring this trimmer right back in. But this time I'm going to gravitate here near the bottom because I'm going to use that dark blade, which is for cutting. So this is where we're going to do a little bit of slicing to make up the pop-up portion. So what I want you to do is I want you to close the card. You're going to see that front crease, but we're just going to keep it shut, and you're going to turn it so that the crease is here at the bottom. I'm going to move that blade down out of the way. I know that it's barely inside your camera view. There's a little glossy glare there from the lights, not too much I can do about it. But I'm going to talk you through this. Let's go ahead and let's open this up, and we are going to line up the left edge here at 1 1/2 inches. So I've got that lined up here. Again, there's that straight little area right here to keep this nice and straight. We are going to position the blade at the 3/4 inch mark. Now keep in mind, it starts here at the 1 and it works its way down. Now I know that's difficult to see, so I put a little tiny black Sharpie dot here with my marker before we got started. I can rub that off very simple with a little piece of alcohol and it'll take it right off. But I wanted to do that because I knew I was using dark cardstock and that would be difficult for you to see. I want you to position your blade where you need to start first, because I find it's very difficult to push the blade up through the fold versus pulling it down. So remember, the crease is here. So I have my blade positioned at that 3/4 inch mark. I'm at the 1 inch and 1 1/2 inch here, and then we are going to pull. Now what I want you to do is go back and forth a couple times, and if your cutter is not the Stampin' Trimmer, which I have to tell you, this thing is amazing, you may have to make a small slit and then come back in with your scissors to go through these layers, and that's okay. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up, and now I'm going to slide over to the 4 inch mark, and we're going to do the exact same thing. So I'm holding my finger here to keep my blade off my paper until I have it aligned where I want it, and then I will just anchor that down, and then we'll pull. And I'm just going to go back and forth over it a little bit. You know, once it's cut a little bit, you can actually feel it, so it makes it a lot easier for your hand. All right, now, do you see how we have a slit here at the top and the bottom? Now, there's a couple things you can do for the next part, which is the scoring. If you are very proficient with your trimmer, you can certainly come in now, and you are going to connect this from this cut line to this cut line, and then from here to here. If you are not comfortable with that, I'm going to give you an alternative, because I don't know about you, but this clear cutting guide is absolutely amazing. So I can make sure my paper is nice and straight. I can see right here where the blade is going to come, and I can actually score. If you're comfortable with that, great. Now, if you're not, I always like to give you another idea. So let me move that out of the way. I am going to leave this wide open, and I'm going to come in with either a ruler. In my case, I love one of these T-rulers. This is fantastic because it's going to keep the top here nice and straight. I can actually see where those end, and I'm going to use this. Now, this is my take your pick tool. It comes with interchangeable pieces. So I'm going to dial this out, and I'm going to add in the stylus tool. Now, one end is a little bigger. This is the smaller end, which is what I like for cardstock. And looking here, I can see where those cuts are aligned, and I'm just going to go over that, and I'm going to score it. Really simple. So you can do this with a ruler, and then I'm going to do the exact same thing here, looking to align those, and I'm going to score it. Nice and simple. All right, now let me set that off to the side for just a moment. And this is where the pop-in comes to play. So you see how I've got my fingers here? All right, so what we're looking to do is we're looking to kind of crease on that little score line that we just made here from the back. And I'm trying to keep it as low as possible so it's nice and focused for you. So we'll crease here, and then this one is going to come forward as well. I like to give them a little bit of a pinch because I don't want to crease the entire back. Now, once I've got a little bit of a crease going there, watch what we're going to do. We can simply fold it. Now, do you see what's happening? This is the pop-up mechanism. So I'm going to fold like so, and I'm going to look, and then I'm going to open this up, and I'm going to come in now with my bone folder, and I'm going to go over those creases just to reinforce this, make everything nice and flat. All right. Now, we're going to set that off to the side for just a moment, and we're going to work on a focal piece we're going to need because there's lots of layers to the inside, but super duper easy. All right, this is a piece of basic white cardstock. And what we're going to do here is we're going to do a little bit of stamping. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to bring in my Smoky Slate ink pad. And I'm going to bring in a Christmas tree image. Now again, remember I have a birthday card for you and several other samples. This happens to come from my very favorite bundle of holiday products called Whimsical Trees. I love it because it's never going to go out of style, and I really like the greetings. So, so pretty. So scratch paper, like I said, so I'm just going to ink this up, and I do better sideways with these nice long, tall images, and we're going to stamp that here. Now, I happen to have my Stampin' Scrub, or in your case, it may be a Stampin' Chamois, just off camera to clean my stamps. I never put my stamps away dirty. I learned that lesson a long, long time ago. How many of you love heat embossing, which means you're going to get that beautiful silverly gold, copper, metallic finish on your cards? So tonight, I decided, you know what? Let's go ahead and let's do that together because it's a small area. So I'm going to bring this in, and you're going to look at this, and you're going to think, what is all this? And I'll explain this to you in just a second. These little containers right here are fantastic. They're little snap containers that I keep my embossing powder in. And I really like this because if I drop it, it's not going to be all over the place. Now here I've got part of a Swiffer cloth, and we're going to talk about that in just a moment. I'm going to put that off to the side. And this is my anti-static embossing powder bag. It's kind of a mouthful. This is no longer a Stampin' Up! Product in my online store, but I didn't link it in my craft room favorites for you. So head over to my website at lisastampstudio.com, click on shop, and you'll see there in the drop down craft room favorites. I've linked this there for you because I can't live without it. Whenever you're going to use detailed stamps, that powder will actually repel the embossing powder from areas that you don't want it. So this little dust bag is wonderful. So I'm just going to kind of shimmy this off to the side for just a minute because I need a little stamping room here for the next layer. Versamark ink is a watermark ink, which looks beautiful on dark cardstock by itself, But I'm going to use it now to put the embossing powder over. So I'm going to turn that sideways and I'm going to ink this up. Now this pad's a little bit spongier, so you're going to want to make sure you don't press too hard. We don't want ink around those negative outside images. And I'm looking, trying to get my head in your camera view. We're going to press and then we are going to immediately bring in the powder. Now you need to do this while the ink is wet. Otherwise, of course, it won't stick. Now do you see how I push too hard? All right. The good news is there is a die for this, so it's going to cut inside of there, so I don't have to worry about it. I actually keep a little tiny paintbrush here in the studio for when I have those aggressive moments. And I kind of just brush off the excess so that it doesn't heat set and come part of the card. Now I'm going to tap off my plastic spoon, and I actually reuse that in other colors. I just wipe it off, and that's part of what this Swiffer dryer sheet is all for. Are you ready? So I'm just going to pick all that excess embossing powder off, and then here's what else I use it for. If you've ever heat embossed before, you'll notice that there's little tiny flecks of embossing powder on your work surface, and that's normal because it's very, very fine. So what you're going to do is you're going to take that, and you're literally going to go over your work surface to clean it up. It's going to pick it all up, and you can use this numerous times. And that's going to keep it nice and clean, which means that powder then will not fall into your ink pads. All right, another tip for you, for those of you that are really kind of gun shy with the embossing gun, I want to talk to you about a paper clip. Some people use tweezers, paper clips, any of those are going to work, but this is where we're going to use the heat tool. Again, this is in my online store, two speeds. I'm going to put it on speed 2, which is the hottest, encased tip, which I absolutely love, which means this is going to retain its heat once it's getting hot. And then you can do multiple cards very, very quickly. So it's gonna be loud, but I think you can still hear me. Again, that gun is nice and cold right now. I recommend that you start in one area at a time, because the worst mistake people do when they're embossing is they go all over the place too quickly. So you wanna make sure that the paper conducts the heat from the tool, and you see what happens? It's gonna start to turn shiny. And then what's going to happen is it's going to help you spread the heat, and it's going to actually keep the paper warm. So all those little powdery areas are going to become beautiful and embossed and slightly raised, and in this case, silver metallic. Now the embossing powders come in different colors. There's a beautiful metallic assortment that's in my online store, and there's also the basic assortment as well. So super simple, not something for the kids to use. This gets very, very hot. So I'm gonna set that off to the side. Gonna remove my paper clip there, and that has left us with this. Ooh, that silver is so pretty, isn't it? Now the one reason I love the stamp set is because it has coordinating dies, but look how many there are. So this one here is what die cut my tree. And just to save space here on the counter tonight during our live stream, I did do that ahead of time, which has left us with this. All right, so let's go ahead now and let's get ready the area that we're gonna need to apply this for this amazing pop out and pull out card. So you'll recall that we have our card here, all right? And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna work on the panels for this card. This part, super duper easy. The next thing I've got here is a square of cardstock, but we are going to cut it on the diagonal. So I'm going to come back to my trimmer, and of course you can do all of this at one time. I'm just walking you through the process so that you can do it at home very easily side by side with me. This black area is where the blade is going to travel to cut the paper. So I'm looking for tip to tip here. Close that clear cutting guide, which I absolutely love, so you can see where you're going. And then all we're going to do is we are going to slice, and that's going to give you two halves. All right, I'm going to go ahead and set that aside as well. And then just before you joined me, I went ahead and I cut a piece of designer series paper. Now all the measurements are inside your project sheet. That's going to make this nice and easy for you. It's just slightly smaller. Now I'm going to speed things up with adhesive tonight, but I do recommend that you use liquid glue. And the reason I do that is because you're going to want to make sure you get glue in those tips so that your paper doesn't lift. Now, if you prefer adhesive like me, you're going to want to make sure you have an adhesive that'll allow you to get really far inside of here. I'm going to go pretty far tonight, and I can always curl back a little bit that I don't need because my Stampin' Seal Plus comes out in little tiny tabs. So I can just kind of curl those to the back. But I do think that liquid glue is probably the easier way to go. And you'll recall me saying that I don't do too many things straight. So you're going to see me making the straight edge here at the top. And then what I'm going to do is just kind of turn this without getting my head in your camera view. And I'm looking to keep a margin across the top and the sides. And then we're just going to anchor that in place. Now, this has a very strategic position here for the entire pullout of this pop-up card. Do you see the bridge here in the center? It's going to go here. So my next step is to go ahead and place adhesive here. Now we're also going to create elements here that overlay this. So you're going to see the score line is right here. So I'm going to look to stay within that perimeter, and I want to make sure I don't go past the score line here. And I'm going to add my Stampin' Seal Plus. My adhesive is very, very strong, so I am not worried that this will not hold. I am going to hold this so that it's like this, so the pop-up is there. I am looking to make sure that this piece lays within the designer series paper area here. So I'm kind of buttoning it up to that little crease line. And then when it looks good, we're simply going to press. And then what's going to happen is now we've got this little lever here for the pullout. But okay, it gets better. And yes, I see Marianne asking if she can use tear and tape, and the answer is absolutely yes. So you're going to cut two of these. They're squares, very simple. And then I cut designer series paper to go with them. Now I've already put one together. I'm just going to go ahead and put this one together with you. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to adhere this here. We are going to put this on the diagonal as well. But this has a strategic location, and believe it or not, we're still not done because there's another layer. All very, very simple. Now, obviously, we're only going to need adhesive on half because this layer is going to fall here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this upside down. And again, you may want to use your liquid glue. Just don't get too far to the outside edges because you don't want it to ooze where it's going to fall here. Okay? So I'm just going to use adhesive for the sake of the demonstration. And I'm going to come here and here, just enough to hold it down. Like I said, this adhesive is really strong. So I'm putting my fingers here to ensure that I have it going the right way, because I've done that. And then what we're going to do is we are looking to put the point here and the point here along this crease for the Z fold. So I'm looking to align the top and the bottom, and then we're going to press that in place. Now, before you go too far, I want you to check from the back. Do you see a little bit of adhesive there? Mm-hmm. Let me show you another use for this amazing little heat embossing powder thing. Are you ready? You're going to take it and you're going to press it right over any adhesive that shows. That actually takes the sticky completely away without having to mar the paper and try to remove it. Because I do have an adhesive remover, but I found because it's right along the edge, it kind of gums up a little bit. This works like a charm and it's not sticky anymore. You don't have to worry about that impeding on your card. Now I do have one other one. Let me show you where this goes. So again, on the diagonal of the back side, we're going to add adhesive here. And wait till you see these other cards. This is my Christmas card, but I have others that are really, really pretty as well. This is going to go to the lower portion. So we're going to leave this open because we have another element to add here. So these are all simple squares that are simply placed on the diagonal. And again, we're going to look here. Yep, I got a little adhesive outside my edge. And then I'm just going to add a little of my powder there, and that's good to go. All right, and this is where your Swiffer comes in really good. So if you got powder on your work surface, great way to pick it up. This area here, remember our Christmas tree? Okay, let's talk about that. Another square, another piece of designer series paper. What I'm going to do is I'm going to place these two together. So I'm going to add adhesive here and here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this to the square. We are also going to work on the diagonal. Now the other card I have to share with you, one of these has a different element here. Wait until you see it. This one again is going to go here, but you can do one of two things. You can place it first or you can decorate it first. Now in my case, I'm going to go ahead and adhere it first. And just like the other one, you want to be very careful on where you're going to place that adhesive. I'm not going to be as excited this time, and I'm not going to go as far over. So I'm going to go ahead and place a little here and here. And again, I know this adhesive is very, very strong, so I don't have to worry about covering every little inch of it. Putting my fingers where there's no adhesive, so I've got the right parameters. I'm looking now to make sure that there's equal margins here as well as here. I'm just trying to visually center it. And then when I'm happy with it, I'm lightly tacking it, and I'm looking, and I'm like, yep, that looks really good. All right, so here is our Christmas tree. I am in love with the silver mesh ribbon. It is absolutely beautiful. It's very wide, so I cut it in half to make it a little narrower for my card. And let me show you what I did here. I'm going to add some adhesive right down here in the middle of that Christmas tree. And this is nothing fancy. As a matter of fact, if you overthink this, you're going to make yourself mad. So you're just going to go back and forth to create a little bit of a zigzag here. We're going to add just a little bit of bling to this. Now I'm going to flip this over and we're going to add some dimensionals. So this will be lifted off that panel. Now I don't want you to miss what's going to happen to the inside of this card. So make sure you're sticking with me. I'm excited to share that with you. And then remember that take your pick tool? Well, let's go back to that interchangeable tip here. I'm going to go back to that paper piercing tool. And that's going to help me remove those backings. That's a lot easier for me with my arthritic hands than trying to pull those off with my fingertips. This now is going to go here. Make sure that you have this going in the right direction so it's all on the diagonal. All right. My tree needs a little bling, and I have another trick for you. If you're going to put the rhinestone or element here, you're going to notice that it's going to fall too shallow. So let me give you a great tip. I want you to grab one of your glue dots. I'm going to pick up one of those here, and I'm going to ball it up really, really small. Now, these are so sticky. You don't ever even have to worry about it losing its stickiness. I am going to place it right at the top of the tree to compensate for the elevation difference. I'm coming over to the silver and clear, a little epoxy droplets, and wait till you see what I do with these. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pull out this diamond-shaped one. And I've got adhesive already on the back of here, so that's going to make it easy. And that's going to go right over that glue dot. Now that take your pick tool is kind of like my third hand. It gets it right on top of there. Now look, everything is exactly at the same elevation. It's a fantastic card making tip. Now you might be wondering, Lisa, where are you going to put the greeting? Well, I've got variations for you, but I want to give you an important tip. I'm going to grab my pencil. And I get so many comments about this pencil. This is in my craft room favorites as well. This Bic pencil has the softest lead I have ever used, and it's the best crafting pencil you'll ever own. The eraser is amazing as well. You are going to do a little bit of tracing so you have an idea of where the greeting is going to fall so that it won't be visible from the front. So what I'm going to do is I'm lightly going to trace here and here, and you may not even be able to see this because I want to make sure it's light enough. I want to make sure that I can erase it. And then when it's open, I want you to trace here and here. Now, remember, your designer series paper or cardstock may be different than mine. You need a parameter of where you're going to stamp. I'm going to use the basic gray ink, and I've pulled out the word Merry Christmas. Now, the ones in this stamp set didn't fit really well here. So this is where you just expound on everything you have, right? I'm using For Unto Us, absolutely gorgeous Christmas stamp set. I'm gonna ink this up, and you know what? I know as sure as I'm standing here, I put that sticker on backwards or crooked. Anybody else with me? So I'm gonna take a small scrap piece of grid paper, and this is where I'm going to test it. And I can see, oh yeah, that sticker was way on there crooked. So I know I need to compensate. Another great tip, because if you're like me and you put them on crooked, there's a way to check before we stamp. Now let's hope for the best. Pencil marks are here, so I know I've got to stay within this area. We're going to hope for the best. Let's see if we can do this. If not, it's another card from my mom. Okay, not too bad. All right, let me close that up. And that's going to give that ink just a second for it to dry. And here comes that magic pencil. This is amazing. Because the lead is so soft, you don't have to worry about when you erase your designer series papers, even those with foils, that it's going to leave marks and mar your surface. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just move all that off. And there we go. We have our card. Is this not spectacular or what? I'm going to give you a quick aerial there. And then let me show you from the backside. But wait until you see these other cards. I mean, they are really, really incredible. Okay, so here's the Christmas one. But here's the one, if you're watching the replay, that is actually in the thumbnail. Do you see the difference here? Look at the center element. This one I did on the diamond to stay with the entire theme. This one I used a circle. Just think of all the different die shapes that you can use to get really fun impressions. This is from Hand Penned and the Coordinating Designer Series paper, but watch for the inside of this. Ready? Oh, look how I use this. That pop-up now is actually housing another small expandable greeting. And again, I was very, very careful where I stamped this by tracing it. I came close, but I made it. And that leaves for this card. But I've got more because I've got more options for you. Now, these two are in the project sheet that you're going to get. These others are actually ones I practice with, because before I ever go live with you, I never come into this cold turkey. I like to make some other cards so I feel like I can explain it well to you. Exact same papers, but this is from the Peaceful Cabin. So definitely more masculine, and this definitely can be a beautiful winter card, wishing you the best. And then this one, of course, I used for a Christmas greeting. All right, pretty, pretty, pretty. All right, I'm gonna keep going. This one, gorgeous, isn't it? Elegantly said, as the stamp said, beautiful designer series paper that goes with it. I added a little bit of gold twine there. Do you see it? Oh, I love foil paper, isn't it pretty? But you're thinking, well, where's the greeting? Well, look, I didn't want to cover up that pretty paper, so look what I did. I put it right back here. So all I did was I added a stamped border from that stamp set. So don't think it all has to be on the inside. And here's another example for you. Sweet as a peach with that really pretty, cheerful designer series paper. Again, this is on the diagonal. And then there are double panels. So do you see how a pop of color on the inside to coordinate with everything here? And then again, I just traced and I placed a white panel here to create some interest here. And you can always add another panel to the back if you wanted. These are really, really stunning cards, aren't they? I would absolutely love to know which one of those is your favorite. Would you leave me a comment below? Now, I wanna go of a couple things with you before we leave. Don't miss that project sheet. You're gonna want those cutting dimensions. It's super easy. The other thing is, we talked about it briefly, but if you're brand new to my website at lisastampstudio.com, scroll down about halfway, you're gonna get a pop-up to join my free weekly e-newsletter. And I would love to have you do so, because I provide a PDF tutorial in that format that is not shared on any of my other platforms. It's a no-frills email, but my customers who get those, or even my followers for my newsletters, are automatically the first one to know about all the great things that are happening, as well as a free tutorial every Thursday. Would love to have you join. I have a vast PDF tutorial library over on my website under the Classes tab. And then finally, I'm switching screens. I want to make sure you don't forget about this. Cyber Monday is a big day here at Lisa Stamp Studio. Enjoy your Thanksgiving this week with family and friends. And then head over to my website at lisastampstudio.com to place your qualifying order for all these special goodies for your Cyber Monday sale. I am so grateful that you guys have joined me. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't, because I'm coming back live with you next Monday, which is November 29th, for a really simple and impressive card you are not going to want to miss. I'm wishing you all a very happy Thanksgiving. I'm grateful for each of you. Gina, thanks for all your help tonight. Bye-bye, everyone.